A limb length discrepancy is just a difference in the lengths between the two legs. And this can be a difference between the heights of the pelvis, the thigh bone, the shin bone, or even the feet, or a combination of any of those. There are wide reasons for why patients develop a limb length discrepancy. There can be a congenital difference between the two bones and how one has formed, causing it to be shorter. Sometimes things that affect the growth plate, such as a fracture, trauma, or infection, can lead to that growth plate growing slower compared to the one on the other side. Or sometimes patients are just born with one leg slightly shorter, and we don't know exactly what the cause is. We diagnose a limb length discrepancy both on a clinical physical examination as well as using radiographs so that we can specifically measure the amount of discrepancy and figure out exactly where that discrepancy is coming from. Surgery can sometimes be required to treat a limb length discrepancy to get the legs to where they're the same length. During growth, sometimes we can take advantage of that and slow down the growth plate on the long leg so that over time the two legs become the same length. Sometimes when a patient is done growing, we can just shorten the long leg, or we can do procedures where we lengthen the shorter leg. Yes, if a limb length discrepancy is small enough, it sometimes doesn't require any treatment. In fact, most people have some amount of discrepancy between their legs and have no idea about it. We can also use shoe lifts that either go on the inside or the outside of the shoe, as well as another non-operative option. To do this, we can do something that's external or that goes around the outside of the leg, or more frequently, we can do something that's internal that goes inside the bone to slowly, less than a millimeter per day, lengthen the limb. This is usually done over several, about three sessions per day, and each session lasts just a few minutes. So there are different stages to the recovery. After surgery, we usually give you a week off where we allow the bone to start laying down some healing factors. And then we actually take advantage of this, and this is when we start to lengthen the bone. And again, very slowly, we lengthen the bone and those healing factors continue to be laid down. Once the length is achieved, then we stop everything and we wait for all of those healing factors to turn into real mature solid bone. This process is really variable based on how much length we're trying to achieve. Yes, so the original studies looking at limb lengthening actually found that everything around the bone, the skin, the muscles, the vessels, the nerves, all grow alongside the bone. And in fact, that's actually a really important part of this process, even though we don't get to see them growing on x-rays. If we lengthen a bone too quickly, that can pull on some of our muscles and tendons, and then they can become tight and lead to our joints, like our hip, our knees, our ankle, becoming stiff, which can cause difficulty during this process. Or if we pull too much on a nerve, that can lead to increasing pain. And so that's why we do it so slowly to reduce the risk of any issues with those. Additionally, we do a lot of physical therapy and stretching to keep everything nice and loose and flexible. And sometimes we also do some bracing to help keep all of our joints nice and limber.